Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this is macOS 13 Ventura. This is the latest version that's currently available to developers. It will be out to public beta testers in July, according to Apple, and then come out to the public and everyone else on supported devices in the fall or autumn, sometimes usually in late September or early October. Now, this particular update is supported on iMac 2017 and later, iMac Pro 2017, MacBook Air 2018 and later, MacBook Pro 2017 and later, Mac Pro 2019 and later, Mac Studio 2022, Mac Mini 2018 and later, and MacBook 2017 and later. So if you have any one of those devices, when this is available to the public, you'll be able to install it. Now, the overall update was only about 3 gigabytes or so, but let's go ahead and talk about what's new. There's quite a few nice changes. The first thing is, if we go to the Apple, go to About This Mac to take a look at the build number, you'll see the About screen has completely changed. So it's all new. It shows what device you're currently using, so the 16-inch MacBook Pro from 2021, and it also says macOS Ventura 13.0. And so I'm going to cover everything new in macOS Ventura that I didn't mention in the initial iOS 16 and iPadOS 16 beta videos. Since many features are very similar across them, and there's hundreds, at this point, we're just going to mention the major changes to Ventura. So be sure to check out the 36-minute iOS 16 video if you're interested in everything after this video. If we click on More Info, it will open up the new System pane. So this replaces Preferences, and now it's System Settings in the upper left that you can see here. It gives all of your information and shows macOS Ventura with the current build number of 22A5266R. It shows the display I'm using with it, and there's quite a few new changes. So the first thing, like I said, is a new settings pane. And as you can see here, you've got your name. This is very familiar if you've ever used iPhone or iPad. It's basically a very similar version of their settings pane. So you have Wi-Fi, you have Bluetooth, you can see all of your devices, you can connect to them. We've got network, you can connect to Wi-Fi, you've got a firewall here that's active. And then you've got everything from notifications, sound, focus, screen time, general, that looks very similar to what we just saw, appearance, and this is where you can change from light to dark mode in auto, accessibility, control center, you'll see Siri and Spotlight, privacy and security, and as we scroll down, you've got all of your different options as well. So desktop and dock, you've got your displays, wallpaper, and under wallpaper, you'll see it looks a little different. So we have our current wallpaper here, and if we scroll down, we have colors. So we can auto rotate colors, add different colors using the color wheel or the color picker, select whatever color we want, add a folder, and even add a photo album that's from photos. So you have all of those options for wallpaper, and they even have the older wallpaper here as well, but not installed by default. So we can go to desktop pictures and scroll down, and you can see here's some of the older desktop pictures. So Big Sur, if we scroll down, we can go to Catalina even. So it's keeping all of those installed. Under screensaver, you'll see it looks pretty much the same. And under battery, we have a battery page that looks very familiar. It shows the battery charging status, battery health, and everything else. So you have on battery, we have it go to automatic, low power, or high power. And then on the power adapter, high power automatically, or you could set it to whatever you'd like. And then, of course, you've got your usage over the next few days. You've got lock screen options, touch ID and password, users and groups, passwords, internet accounts, and everything else. So that's something that's been updated, completely new preference or settings pane. Now, if we click off of this, one thing I noticed right away is you'll see here at the top, if I click on this, it says link keyboard and mouse to Mac Studio. The Mac Studio is nearby, and so you can actually link it. And now it just switched off, but it was here for a little while, and for some reason it went away. But when the Mac Studio is awake, it will show up, and then I'll be able to just instantly switch between keyboard and mouse on different devices. So it's very simple that way, and something that's really nice, much easier than plugging in your keyboard and mouse every single time. Now, something new that has to do with system settings is under general and then software update. Just like iOS and iPadOS, Apple also now has the ability on macOS to install security updates without having to install the whole OS again. So they call this rapid response, and they say now your Mac will get important security updates between normal software updates, so you automatically can stay up to date and protected against security issues. So that's something that they've updated in this version. Another thing they've added is something we haven't had in macOS for a long time or ever, and that is the clock. You'll see we have the clock app now. So here's the regular clock app, just like we have on iPhone and iPad. We have our stopwatch, our timer, and our alarm. Also, you may have already noticed, we also have a weather app. Apple has finally brought weather to macOS. So it's the same weather app that we have on iPad, looks basically the exact same. And if we click on it here, you can see your location. You can see all the different information and details about temperature and forecasts and more. So the exact same app that we have on iOS now. It's great to have these across all different devices. One of the big features of macOS Ventura is called Stage Manager. Stage Manager can be turned on by going to the Control Center, and under Control Center, you'll see a new icon here called Stage Manager. If we click on it and activate it, you'll see everything looks pretty much the same now, but if I open up an app, maybe weather, then maybe open up, let's open up preferences or settings, you'll see that weather moves to the left. Then if we open up Safari, give it just a moment here, we'll go to Apple, and you'll see everything starts moving to the left, and you can organize this by windowing it. So just dragging your different applications that are open over the top, you can resize them, click on the other, and it sort of organizes it by itself. So if I click on what's on the left here, so I have Safari and Weather together, it keeps them together, but you can still drag and drop between each one of these. So maybe I want to drag a file from one to the other, you can drag between them. So it's a new way of organizing your desktop, and this is also on M1 iPads. So this is something they've brought across to both of them. So it works with Mission Control as well. So if you have Mission Control active, you can use this along with it. Now I have that as a hot corner and it's not working right now. So there are some bugs in here. So you'll see it goes to the desktop here, should go to Mission Control in the bottom left, but it keeps glitching here. But we do have desktop in my hot corner in the bottom right, and you'll see it clears it even if you're in Stage Manager. And if you don't like that, you can just turn it off. So turn it off, you can show recent apps or hide recent apps. So that's been updated in macOS Ventura. Now Apple has updated the Home app as well. And now I'm only going to show you the changes that are new to macOS as opposed to things that carry across everywhere. But I did show this before, but since this is a Mac specific app, we have an all new Home app with all of our different devices. So they've redesigned this to make it easier to use. If we click on lights, you'll see all our different lights. At the top, we have security. You'll see a camera there. It's just not active because I'm in the room with it. We've got our speakers. We have one that's not plugged in, and then also the same thing on the left. We can set up automations, go to home, change it based on where you're located, and so on. So it has this as well as Matter support in the future. So all of those things are available in macOS Ventura. Now, one of the next things that's pretty nice is FaceTime. FaceTime can now be handed off from your iPhone to your Mac to your iPad. So if you're in a FaceTime call, you can hand off between the different applications or different devices, and it will switch over the application, bringing Bluetooth headphones along with it. So you'll see all my different Bluetooth headphones. If I'm using my AirPods 3, it will carry those across to those devices. So let's go into FaceTime. I'm in FaceTime and I have all of my typical FaceTime options. As you can see up here at the top, we have waiting for others because I'm just calling myself. And then you have your typical options with collaboration tools that have been added also. Now, along with this, if I go over to my iPhone, there's an icon that shows up automatically in a FaceTime call. And if I tap on it, it allows me to switch to that device. So you can see that you can switch to the device and it will just switch seamlessly between them. Now, sometimes it's a bit buggy since this is an early version, but it does seem to work. There's a new feature in FaceTime called Continuity Camera. You can use your existing iPhone camera, and I just have it set up on a tripod here. You'll see there's a monitor, my computer's over here, my MacBook, and it's just connected, and the iPhone will connect wirelessly. So if I open up FaceTime, it will automatically turn on and connect to the iPhone. So you'll see I'm in a FaceTime call, and I'm actually using the camera from the iPhone 13 Pro Max. So if I cover the lens, you can see that it's actually using that camera in real time wirelessly. We also get some effects with that as well. So it's a pretty nice setup where we have portrait mode. Of course, we're using the better camera from the back of the iPhone. And then if we go to the control center, click on video effects, we now have studio light. It will darken the background and bring my face to the forefront, just like I had a light on front of me. Or we have desk view. Desk view allows you to see the desk in front of you. So it's using the ultra wide camera, as you can see here, to show the desk below me in real time. We can zoom in, We can zoom out and it's showing the desk and we can arrange things in real time and just using all from one camera. It's using the ultra wide to do this and processing the information using the neural engine. Now, also you may have noticed it has center stage. So as I move, it will actually follow me. If I move out of the frame, it will follow me around just like all of the different devices with center stage. And all of that just comes to any of the Macs that are supported with this. So you can just wirelessly connect the iPhone, and then you have different options, of course, for collaboration and more. So you can show your windows on your desktop, and then also your screen as well. And then you can see here when we go to the camera options, it says iPhone 13 Pro Max. So that, as well as the microphone options here too. So you have MacBook Pro or iPhone 13 Pro Max. It works pretty seamlessly. And for being an early beta, I'm pretty impressed with it. Mail on Mac gets the same updates as you get on iOS and iPadOS. You now have scheduled send, remind me, and undo send for up to 10 seconds. You also have improved search that even if you place a typo in the search bar, it will still find things that are related to what you were probably searching for. So it will auto-correct that and then look it up based on that information. Also, you have updated Spotlight search. You can click the little magnifier here or hit command space, and then you can search for all sorts of things. It shows personalized suggestions from the web, and then also it allows you to find things such as contacts, albums, musicians, movies, TV shows, actors, sports, and businesses. And you can view them large, and also maybe we'll search for cars. We'll search for pictures of cars. It will find pictures of cars not only online, but also in our photo library. And if we click on one, hit the space bar, we can also use preview now. So we also have Spotlight preview, just like we do across the whole OS. So this is something that's really nice. It's also finding those images across the entire system. You can also set an alarm. So set an alarm for 30 minutes. And you have that option. So Siri suggested websites, or if we click on this, we can set an alarm. Now it's not working 100% right now, but you should be able to do that in the future. Additional things you can do are start a focus, run a shortcut, and find the name of a song all within Spotlight search. So all of those things are coming a little bit later. Now we also have quite a few accessibility features built into macOS. If we go into our system settings and we go to accessibility, we have similar accessibility settings compared to what we have on iOS and iPadOS. So we now have background sounds. So there's background sounds built in here. You can play the background sounds, choose your background sound, just like you can on iOS. You also have live captions. So when you're in a FaceTime call, you can use live captions. And I haven't been able to get this to work yet, but it is an option where you can actually talk and it will show live captions. If we go back into FaceTime, so live captions is in beta and you can just turn it on here. Now I haven't successfully seen this work yet, but it should be working by the time it's released. So maybe it's working for you. And if it is, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. You also have VoiceOver, and VoiceOver has 20 additional languages. Now Apple doesn't say what all of the languages are, but you have Bengali. You also have Bulgarian, Catalan, Ukrainian, and Vietnamese, and more. There's 20 total that they've added. And then you also have Type to Speak on Mac to have your Mac speak out loud for you during a phone call, FaceTime call, or any video conferencing app. So if you have that turned on, you can actually type while you're speaking. Maybe on a FaceTime call, you have trouble speaking, you can just type it out and it will speak it for you. If you're using VoiceOver, it also has a built-in text checker. So it looks for grammatical errors such as duplicates, spaces, mistaken capitalized letters, and more. And then also you get that buddy controller option. If you're playing a game, you can pair two controllers and control them simultaneously so that you can help each other get through a game. So all of those accessibility features are built in. Now there's additional updates to Safari as well. Now I showed Safari on iOS, but if we go into Safari, open it up, they're now claiming that it's the world's fastest web browser. They base this off of tests conducted on a 13-inch MacBook Pro with an M1, 8 gigs of RAM, and 512 gig SSD with a pre-release version of Ventura. So they even said that they had a WPA2 Wi-Fi network connection while running on battery power with display brightness set to 8 clicks from the bottom or 50%, testing performance overall, saying that it was just faster than Chrome or other browsers such as Microsoft Edge and Firefox. So they claim it's the fastest now. And also you have shared tab groups now. So if you have a tab group, maybe this Apple one here, or I was looking for bathtub parts, you can now share this tab group with someone else and have all of your tab groups across a different group of people so you can share anything you're working on. So this sharing or sort of collaboration is built across the entire system. Now also we're going to have passkey support in the future if a website supports it, meaning you'll no longer need a password to log in. And let me show you how that works. And on this website, we'll just click sign in and this will show you how passkey will work. You'll no longer need a password, but you can use your iPhone, iPad, or Android device or an external security key. Click continue and then you can scan a QR code and then it will allow you to sign in. So that allows you to sign in seamlessly using your phone without a password. So hopefully we're moving on to a passwordless future where it's more of a biometric security system, and it's a lot harder to actually scam someone or phish their information. Now, additionally, there's updates to system. So you have Metal 3 support for better gaming. And then also anytime you connect a USB device, it will now prompt you to actually allow it. So you cannot immediately transfer information. So if we plug in a different device here, it includes keyboards, a mouse, trackpads, anything that connects to USB-C. Plug it in. I just plugged in my iPad and immediately it says allow accessory to connect. A USB accessory was attached to this Mac. Do you want to allow it? If you allow it, then it can connect. So otherwise, it will not be able to transfer any information whatsoever. Now, additionally, if you have an iPad Pro 12.9 inch with a Liquid Retina XDR display or the latest mini LED display, you'll see if we go into our settings, go to displays, we can add the display and use it for a reference display. So you'll see here we can select from iPad Pro, fifth generation, click on that, give it just a moment to connect. And you can now have some options for it. If you click on it, you'll have all your different options and you can use it as a reference display to be color accurate for whatever you're doing here. So that's something that they've mentioned. You can actually turn on reference modes on the iPad itself, which I showed in my iPadOS video. So that's everything in macOS Ventura. There's a ton of different changes. Most of them are very simple, but very helpful, especially the new system settings. But additionally, there are a bunch of changes and updates that are on iOS and iPadOS that are little touches here and there that just improve things. So I didn't mention all of those, such as being able to change your message after you've sent it in messages and much, much more. If you found anything that you haven't seen mentioned anywhere else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.